I've had a couple of struggling names, sorry. And as part of that journey, I went to Detroit. I visited a company called Detroit Soup. I don't know if any of you have heard of Detroit Soup before. But it's a funding initiative that started in Detroit, whereby they call them micro-granting dinners. So basically, four local people get the opportunity to speak for 4 minutes and pitch for some money. And the money that they win is the $5 donation that everybody who attends is paid to attend. And for the $5, they get the person who's paying gets a vote for who they want to win the money, and they also get a bonus. The idea is that even if the person doesn't give money, that you meet other people who may be able to help you with your business, and also make connections with kind of the right people. And the idea is to help you set the barriers very low for entry, so that it's inclusive and you get a wide range of people. So when I met with that company, I thought it would be something great that we can do in Nottingham, where as scholars we commit to making an impact on Nottingham when we come back, and I can see this making a tangible difference. So when I returned, I met a lady called Debbie Clark, Debbie Dudar, as you may know her. She was running a First Tuesday at the time, and I did a speaking event, and I was speaking there and saying how I'd really love to get this started in Nottingham, but kind of probably need a bit of help with how to get this on the ground. And she was on board straight away, and I loved the idea, let's make this happen. And we actually got another couple of ladies involved. And in October 2017, we did our first Not Soup. We Think and Gia Compton Chambers, they hosted the event. Beth was at the kiosk at the time, she made all the soup for the event, and we had 70 people turn up to our first event, and they won, the person who won £340, and it was a lady called Hillary, and it was for her to create a dementia work group in the inner city area. She wanted to get a more multicultural, diverse group that did activities for people with dementia. So that was the first one back in, I said October, it was in March 2017, the first one. And then we did another one later that year, where a couple who had suffered child loss, they set up a charity at the city hospital, which was a garden space where big grief parents could, it was a space for them to go, it was a quiet space where they could grow plants and things like that. And the idea was that watching someone else grow would help them through their traumatic time. So they won. And then after that, the NRMTS expanded in a different way. So the ladies at Think came up with the initiative to do mental health specials. So now what we do is twice a year during Mental Health Awareness Week, we have a mental health special NRMTS where all the ideas are submitted to use arts and creativity to help support people with mental health issues. And we have other sponsors as well, and the Institute of Mental Health, they also donate to the fund. And actually, your mum was the first winner of the mental health lawsuit. Oh my God, I've got to pass around. So these are the first things, so I'll pass those around. Harriet's mum, Bethany. She was the first winner, and I just wanted to read out one of her quotes and what she said, and I think this really kind of sums up the impact it had. So what Beverly did was ran a group of sessions with girls aged 10 to 16 from disadvantaged backgrounds, which they called Girls Empowered. I'll read you a quote. So we had a focus group session to explore their development priorities and the sorts of activities the girls would like to do. We then integrated the Quick to Succeed workshops they had chosen for creative activities. The aim was to raise aspiration, build self-belief and develop resilience to help the girls handle challenges. So we saw the girls build confidence, self-belief and develop a positive candid attitude. The outcome of the Girls Empowered project was so positive it led to many more empowering experiences for the girls. The girls were featured in the 2018 Women of Nottingham exhibition, celebrating 100 years of the Red Women. It also led to a year-long Girls Aiming High programme. This culminated in an enterprise, and the girls created a Women Aiming High community exhibition, which was attended by the Council of Park and the Lord Mayor. a celebration event recognising achievements of confidence in girls, I still get feedback from the girls who participated and their mothers to say what a positive difference the project has made. Some of their mums also decided to participate in the personal development programmes as a result of the outcomes they saw with their daughters. We've got some pictures here of girls and what they achieved and the sort of things that they made. So, on when Beverly won, she won £635, yet she made such an impact to 12 girls and their families, and that impact's everlasting to go on. And I think when I think of impact and to do with the scholarship and what to do, I don't necessarily think it's about money that you're bringing after and things like that. It's mainly about the amount of people you can help and touch. And not suits really done that. And Tony's done it before. We had 7 not suits, we've given out over £4,000. And it's just an endless amount of people. For example, someone from Brainwork, the Kenneth, he won £500 and used it to buy circus equipment, where he was holding 10 sessions with people who were Framework users to help them do these sort of circus activities to help their mental well-being and things like that. And it's like he showed us pictures of all the different people that were doing it, and he's got that equipment now forever. He keeps using that again and again and again. So kind of impact's kind of perpetual in that sense. And so we're going to continue doing this, the NOSUs, twice a year as mental health specialists. And yeah, if it wasn't for scholarship, we wouldn't have been able to do that. I think in terms of that was my initial impact once the scholarship was done. And I took a corporate job, even though kind of my scholarship was about sort of social innovation and social enterprise. But actually that's led to me, I work for Experian, we have a global social innovation committee. And actually, from what I've learned from the scholarship and the experience that I had, it's actually enabled me and a team of people in my work to win a 6-figure sum of money to do a social innovation project here in the UK, where we're trying to help tackle the use of high-cost credit, so payday loans and things like that. We're trying to come up with a real innovative solution to stop people needing to rely on that. And without a scholarship, I never would have been able to pitch to the such senior people and do that. It's the confidence that the scholarship gave me that helped me to that. So thank you.